सदाशिव समारंभां शंकराचार्य मध्यमावस्मदाचार्य पर्यंता वंदे गुरुपरंपरां श्रुति स्मृति पुराणानामालयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादं शंकरं लोकशंकरं शंकरं शंकराचार्यं केशवं बातरायणं सूत्र भाष्यकृतौ वंदे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्तिभेद विभागिनी व्योमवद्व्याप्तदेहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः सहना भवतु सह नौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै ओम शांति शांति शांति। ओम यो ब्रह्माणुदातगुरो येदागुश्च प्रविणोति तस्मै तगुमहदेवमात्म बुद्धि प्रकाश मुमुक्षुरुहि शरणम् अहम् प्रपद्ये। ओम शांति शांति शांति। आम्ना यंतिक संसिद्धमादि मध्यांत वर्जितम् आनंदघनम् आपूर्णमात्म ज्योतिरुपास्महे। So, the 24th sutra which we are looking at, Anyadhishthiteshu Purovad Abhilapat. So, even in the case of Vrihadi, association of the Jiva till the Panchamahuti, whereby the Jiva is really born into the Sharira, the association is Purovat, like earlier. Meaning, how there was association with Akasha Sadrushya and Vayu Sadrushya ending with Varsha Sadrushya, similar is the association with the Vrihyadi Upadhi. So, Anyadhishthiteshu Api, so you can say also what? Purovad. Why? Hetu is abhilapat. So anya here is anya jiva adhishthita. So anya jiva adhishthita vrihyadi, in them there is a purovad association, samsarga. Why? Because abhilapat, such a thing has been mentioned. Without the karma leading to such a phala, the samsarga with the vrihyadi sharira, meaning the crops, have the jiva already present, whose karma phala is association, tadatmya sambandha with that sharira, who takes oneself as that vrihyadi crops, that kind of a living being. However, this traveler jiva has association which is not tadatmya sambandha. He has pravesha only to reach the end goal, which is janma in a particular sharira, most likely human body. So he is waiting for his janma in the womb. Till then he just associates as a traveler with the vrihyadi crops. Then we saw atra purvapakshe vrihyadi janmanah mukhyatve anushayinam tatpariharaya adhikarna adhikam prayatitavyam siddhanti tadiya samsarga matram nirakartum na adhikam prayatitavyam iti phalabheda. So prayatna is more as per the purvapakshi to disassociate from the vrihyadi sharira, whereas siddhanti says that there is no such effort needed. Little effort is sufficient. Adhikam na prayajitavyam. Why? Because tadya samsarga matram nirakartum. Only some kind of a traveler sambandha is there. That alone has to be broken. It does not take much of an effort. Further, tasmin neva avarohe tahiya vrihi yava oshadi vanaspatayaha tilamasha iti jayante iti shruyate. So what is heard in the Shruti, tasmin neva avarohe, in that section of avarohana of the jiva from the chandraloka to the bhuloka, tahiya vrihi yava oshadi vanaspataya tilamasha iti jayante. What is heard? They are born as vrihi yava, so as rice, barley, oshadi, vanaspati, all that, or tilamasha, tila. all these are known words, tila or masha. So you can just take some grains, set of grains there. Masha iti jayante iti shruyate. This has been heard in the shruti. Tatra kim vrihyadi shabhavena jivanam janishrutihi mukhya uta jivantrena adishtite vrihyadu samsargamatram iti vishaye mukhya iti purvapakshaha. So is this janma? Jayante means janma is there. So in the form of vrihi or yava, aushadi or vanaspati or tila or masha, jiva takes janma has been said. Is that janma mukhya or not? It's a jani shruti. Janma shruti, jani shruti, jiva nam janma shruti or jani shruti. It is talking about janma of the jivas. In which form? Vriyadi bhavena. In the form of vri ityadi. So there in that mantra, is that jani shruti mukhya? Is that janma literal for the jiva who is traveling? Uta jivantrena adishtite vrihadav samsargamatram iti vishay. I forgot to underline these. I have already underlined these, but I forgot to export it as a PDF. The moola has been underlined there in the document, but I forgot to upload the PDF there. Update and upload the PDF. So anya jivaihi adishtite. Anya adishtite shu means what? Anyaihi jivaihi adishtite. Adishtite or adishtite shu in plural. It's taking a singular to explain. Bhagavan Sadashiva Brahmendra. He says anyaihi jivaihi adishtite vrihadu. Says vrihi ityadi is already in the form of a crop. When the jiva falls into onto the bhumi, when the jiva in the form of varsha falls into the bhumi or varsha sadrusha falls into the bhumi, onto the bhumi, then it is not that he is going to wait for some seed to be sown, enter that seed and then it grow. After a long time when it grows to be the crop of rice, there is no such wait. What happens is that the crops are already there and then the jiva would enter such crops just as a traveler. So anyehi jive adishtite, already such vrihadi is there. Vrihado anyehi jive adishtite vrihado. The vrihi ityadi already has jiva associations. Which jivas? Those jivas who are getting that janma as a karma phala, their karma phala. And then samsarga bhava manushainam bhavati. In such kind of a vrihyadi crops, there is samsarga bhava for the anushai. Anushai is a traveler jiva who has shesha karma. So those get only samsarga bhava. Samsarga bhava is just mere association, some sambandha to make the travel possible. Kutaha, why does the Siddhanti interpret so? To that, Siddhanti answers, Purvavad Abhilapat. Purvavad Abhilapat is Moola. Because it has been said that the travel is similar to the way it is earlier. Yatha Akashadi Varshanta Teshu, that is Purvavad. Begin with Akasha Sadrushya and ending with Varsha Sadrushya. Karma Paramarsham Antrenaiva Pravesha Ukta. What has been said is that without discussing the karma of the jiva, which jiva? This Anushayi jiva who is traveling, who has shesha karma after the exhaustion of punya leading to Swargavasa. After the exhaustion of that, the jiva comes down from Swarga to Bhuloka. That avarohana is mentioned by mere association with Akashadi Varshanta without discussing that jiva's karma. There is no karma sambandha there. Meaning karma phala is not discussed there at all. So karma paramarsha mantrene eva pravesha uktaha. So it is just mere travel. There is nothing as a karma phala due to which karma phala, which is association with Akashadi Varshanta. There is no karma discussed due to which there is karma phala, which is association with Akashadi Varshanta. Means sadrishya. There is sadrishya has to be read. Akashadi Varshanta sadrishya association is not due to some karma. It is not a karma phala. There is no such discussion. There is no such mention in any shastra. पूर्ववद अभिलापात मीनिंग यथा आकाशादि वर्षांतेषु कर्म परामर्शम अंतरेण विदाउट सच कर्म परामर्श इंक्वायरी इनटू कर्म विच लेड टू दैट काइंड ऑफ अ लेट काइंड ऑफ एन एसोसिएशन विदाउट दैट प्रवेश उक्त प्रवेश संसर्ग मात्र दैट प्रवेश संसर्ग मात्र एवं गृहादिष्वपि कर्म परामर्शम विना एव प्रवेशाभिलापात सिमिलरली व्हाट सिमिलरली देयर इज अभिलाप देयर इज प्रवेश ऑफ द जीव मेंशनड इन व्रीहादि क्रॉप्स दि व्रीहादि इत्यादि अंकुरास विदाउट कर्म परामर्श विदाउट देयर इज विदाउट अ डिस्कशन ऑन दैट बीइंग अ रिजल्ट ऑफ अ पर्टिक्युलर कर्म देयर इज नो सच इंक्वायरी देयर इज नो सच डिस्कशन अतः कर्म परामर्शाभावात् न व्रीहियादिषु अनुशयिनां सुख दुख भोक्तृत्वम् Thereby, what can you understand? You can understand that since there is no discussion of karma or there is no mention of karma which leads to such kind of a phala. Just like earlier, in the earlier sections, there was a discussion as to which karma leads to swargavasa. Ishtadi karma, ishtapurta ityadi karma will lead to chandraloka, swargaloka, anubhava. So the two margas also were discussed with particular kind of karma. Ishtadi, karinam, margadvayam. And the tritiyam sthanam was what? That was for the anishtakari. So anishtadikaris, those who have done papa karma, for them the tritiyam marga, adhogati, jayasva, mriyasva was mentioned. So their karma was discussed. Here karma is not being discussed. Ataha karma paramarsha abhavat na vrihi adishu anushayinam sukadukha bhoktrutvam. Therefore, just like in Chandraloka, Swargaloka there is sukha, and in the insect kind of form there is continuous birth and death, and thereby there is dukha. In adogati, tiryagadi yoni there is dukha. Such Sukha and Dukha cannot be the resultant when karma is not discussed whereby such phala is attained. Therefore, without karma, if some association is given, then that association is not a karma phala. Therefore, there cannot be any Sukha Dukha Bhoga. So what is it then? It is only a mere transport mechanism to land in a particular Sharira, which is the destiny of the Jiva as per Prarabdha. Which is a part of the Sanchita accumulated, which is called as Shesha Karma by the word Anushayi. This Jiva who has come from the Chandraloka, because his Prarabdha is due from the Sanchita, that is Shesha Karma, he is Anushayivan, Anushayavan or Anushayi, and thereby the destination of this Jiva is another Sharira. All the Sharira Sadrishya or the Shariras that this Jiva enters, Pravesha which is mentioned, Pravesha Ukta, all that is a mere association for the resultant transport which finally will lead to the Prarabdha Kruta Janma. Evam Vriha Adishyopi Karma Paramarsham Vinayeva Pravishabhilapath, what will happen? Your analysis will lead to Ataha Karma Paramarshabhavat न व्रीहि आदिषु अनुशयिनां सुखदुःख भोक्तृत्वम् देयर इज नो सुखदुःख भोक्तृत्व दिस देयर इज नो सुखदुःख भोगा फॉर दिस जीवा हु इज अनुशयी हु इज शेषकर्मवान हु इज ट्रैवलर टिल ही एंड्स अप इनटू द फाइनल प्रारब्ध कृत जन्म इनटू अ पर्टिकुलर वूम दिस जीवा डजंट एंटर अंटिल देन देयर इज नो सुखदुःख देन इन द The Matu Sharira, there is in the Garbha, in the Matuhu Garbha, there starts the Sukha Dukha Bhoga there. There is Dukha when is hungry and then due to the darkness and the filth surrounding. But then when the hunger is satiated by the mother's food, then there is Sukha. So this Sukha Dukha Bhoga starts in the womb, but
until then, till the jiva does not get this prarabdha krita sharira, all the sharira associations are mere associations for fructifying the travel. Yatra tu tad bhoktrutvam tatra karma paramarsha ramaniya charana ityadina drishyate. However, if had there been any karma paramarsha inquiry into karma which led to such kind of a janma, wherever it is valid, there bhoktrutvam being there, karma paramarsha would have been talked about, just like in the case of ramaniya charanaha. Those who have ramaniya acharana, they are the ishtadhikaris and they will get chandraloka vasa. So there such shruti is heard. Ityadina drishyate shruyate ityartha. Anyatra yatra na shruyate na drishyate tatra karma paramarsham vina eva pravesha ukta. That is the meaning. Without karma paramarsha, wherever there is an association mentioned, it is just mere association, pravesha. It has nothing to do with the karma phala. Therefore, there cannot be any bhoktrutvam of sukha or dukkha. Tasma janishruti samsarga matra abhipraya. So, janishruti is what? This janma shruti which you quoted, says Siddhanti to the Puro Pakshi, tahya vrihi yava oshadi vanaspataya tilamasha iti jayante, that janishruti is samsarga matra abhipraya. Bhauri, meaning what? That shruti is strilinga. Shruti is strilinga, therefore, samsarga matra abhipraya is स्त्रीलिंग शब्द. सो संसर्ग मात्रम और संसर्ग संसर्ग मात्रम अभिप्रायः यस्याः श्रुतेः सा श्रुतिः संसर्ग मात्राभिप्रायः न मुख्या इति सिद्धम. सो गौण मीनिंग हुज अभिप्राय इज ओनली टू टॉक अबाउट संसर्ग, ओनली मियर संसर्ग, मियर एसोसिएशन, नॉट एसोसिएशन विथ तादात्म्य संबंध वेर देर इज भोक्तृत्व. It is like, you know, you are traveling and you are staying in a particular, dharmashala or a hotel or something, and the hotel walls are being banged. But you do not feel any pain due to the hotel walls being banged. Like we saw the car example, but the owner of the hotel, he will feel that, oh, as if, you know, he is being banged. Especially if it is, you know, something that he is not breaking. He is not breaking the wall, somebody else. You know, like we hear about the stories in Uttar Pradesh of the criminals being treated the way, by breaking, maybe those who have broken the law, bulldozer Baba. So what we hear about their build structures, illegal structures being brought down. So something like that, just an aside. So tasma jani shruti samsarga matra abhiprayana mukhya iti siddham. There is no mukhyatvam in the shruti. It is not literal. This janma shruti, jani shruti is not literal. Ashuddham iti chen na shabdat. Ashuddham iti chen na shabdat. So next sutra in continuation, there is no sangati there. So Purva Pakshi says, अशुद्धम इति चेत. सो व्हाट इज दिस? फर्स्ट लेट्स लुक एट पदच्छेद. अशुद्धम इति चेत न शब्दात. सो देर आर सम हु से दैट देर इज दुख फॉर द जीवा हु कम्स डाउन फ्रॉम द स्वर्गलोक टू द भूलोक. व्हेन दिस जीवा ट्रेवल्स विथ संसर्ग, meaning association with what? With akashadi varshanta sadrishya something. Something which is similar to akasha, something which is similar to, in subtlety, to akasha, ending with varsha. Some association is there. That association will cause dukkha. It is not easy to say, you know, not feel when you are actually coming down from the akasha as varsha finally onto the bhumi. So if you are associated, how is it that you will not feel pain? This is the question raised by some darshanikas. So I think Sankhyas are one of those. Sankhyas, I think we had mentioned this earlier, I'd seen somewhere as well. Sankhyas also opine that what happens is that this person who has gone to Swarga, this Jiva who has gone to Swarga, not person per se, this Jiva who has gone to Chandraloka Swarga as a karma phala of his Yagadi karma, Ishtadi, Ishtapurtadi karma, there he would have done Yaga also in the earlier Janma, which has led to Swarga phala, because without such karma, getting Swarga Loka Vasa is not possible. Therefore, what do we understand? This person has done Yaga. What kind of Yaga has he done? Nitya Naimittika. In the Nitya Karma also, there is not only Agnihotra, which is a very short karma. There is also Darshapurnamasa. Darshapurnamasa, or he may have done Kamya Karma also, whereby he wanted Swargavasa, because just mere Nitya Karma may or may not lead to Swarga. It may lead to Pitraloka, but Swargaloka Vasa means he has done Kamya Karma, and Kamya Karmas have Pashu Himsa. Pashu has to be offered as a Bali. So if that is the case for towards Indra, so Indra expects a Bali to be given. Now it's a different matter that it is, although it is Himsa, it is not Papa Karma. However, how can Himsa not be Papa Karma? This is a question raised by the other Darshanikas. Purva Mimamsakas and Uttar Mimamsakas, Vedantis, do not consider it as a Papa Karma, because for a simple reason, it is ordained. Shruti says something, you do this. It is Himsa, but it is not Papa Karma. But if it is for Swabhoga, without any vidhi, if somebody is killing, you know, hunting for the purpose of entertainment, not a dharma karya, that is a dharma karya, that will lead to papa. Or killing for the purpose of, you know, just because somebody feels that this is good for my health, or people like the taste, therefore they start killing animals and consuming them, then that is a papa karma. Because of what reason? Himsa. So Himsa should not be done because it is papa, is valid all over as an utsarga, as a general rule. However, exception is what? Exception if it is ordained by the Shruti. If it is ordained by the Shruti, then there is no there is Himsa, all right. Himsa we are not denying, but it is ordained by the Shruti. Therefore, it is Punya Karma, not Papa Karma, if somebody does that. Why is it Punya Karma? Because the Shruti says that if you offer Bali of a particular Pashu in the Yaga, then that Pashu will get higher Janma. The Yajamana will get Swargaloka, Punyaloka, but the reason is because he has also freed the particular Pashu. Which Pashu? That Pashu which is actually ready to be offered to the Devata in the Yaga, so that it can be free from the Pashu Janma. In fact, it is said that the mantra uccharana, if done right, then this Pashu will itself go and place itself on the sacrificial post. The Pashu itself goes and pulls out its neck. I have heard it from multiple sources that the Pashu is happy to offer its Bali, which cannot be seen in any other karma. It is only in that particular karma with such mantra uccharana, which shows that this Pashu is ready. In a sense, the prarabdha in the Tiryag Janma, the Pashu Janma is over. Such kind of Pashu, because even in Shruti, particular things are said as to what kind of a Pashu should be offered, what should not be offered. So there is an identification also. Anyway, all this is an aside, just to justify that it is a Punya Karma, not a Papa Karma. However, other Darshanikas say that it is a Papa Karma because of Himsa. Himsatvat. Their hetu is Himsatvat. Meaning Ahimsa Paroma Dharma, having said that, and Mahimsyad Sarva Bhutani, that Shruti says that you should not do Himsa to any Pashu, and then one offers pashu in the yaga, therefore it is a himsa karma and thereby papa. To that the answer is it is not so. Why? There is an upadhi to that tarka. Meaning Bauddhas or Jainas or even Sankhyas, it is said. What Sankhyas say, I'll just mention that since I mentioned Sankhyas. What Sankhyas say is that when the Jiva comes from the Swargaloka down to the Bhuloka, all the associations that he has, these are causing some dukkha. Falling, giving, trying to give up a particular body, entering another body, then, whatever, lightning, etc. You can imagine lightning that occurs when he has a form of a cloud, banging with the other cloud, all these will cause pain. Finally, Vrihadi also, when he gets associated with the rice crop, etc., there, being cut or being stepped upon, all this will cause dukkha. This is all phala of the balance papa. There is a punya papa mix in the pashu yaga that this jiva has done in earlier janma or janmas. There the punya part he has already done bhoga of punya phala by swargaloka vasa. Now the papa which is left is presented to him, the result of that is presented to him in the form of this travel where he has dukkha. This is what the Sankhyas say. What do the Bauddhas, etc. say? They use Anumana because they don't have a Shruti Pramana, they don't consider Shruti as Pramana. So they say, Kartrantra Vartini Himsa Adharma Janika Himsa Tvat Kratu Bahya Himsa Vat. So they use Anumana, they say, Kratu Antarvartini Himsa. The Kratu is a Yaga. Antarvartini means within. Within the yaga, himsa, which himsa? Pashu bali ityadi, pashu himsa, that is adharma janika. It will generate adharma, meaning papa janika ityartha. Why? Himsa tvat, because it is a himsa. Himsa will result in papa. They also have some kind of a karma yavastha without the shruti as pramana, as they say, but it is all the Bauddhas where Sanatanis earlier, they have actually taken all these ideas from the Shruti itself. There is no Pramana otherwise for Papa, Punya, Ityadi. So the Kratu Antarvartani Himsa is Adharma Janika. Why? Just because it is Himsa. Himsatvat is the Hetu. What is the example? Kratu Bahya Himsavat. Just like the Himsa done outside the Kratu, outside the Yaga. Any Himsa done is outside the yaga, is it adharma janika or not? We'll say yes, it is adharma janika. Then the papa will result even from the himsa done within the yaga. So if there is himsa outside the yaga which is adharma janika, papa janika, then the himsa done within the yaga is also adharma janika. Why? Because himsatvam is common. Himsatvam is common between both, therefore himsatvat. So the Nayayika's answers to this, Nayayika say that you are using Nyaya, we will tell you what is the flaw in your Nyaya. You have an Upadhi in the Nyaya. What is the Upadhi? Upadhi is Sadhya Vyapakatve Sati Sadhana Avyapakatvam. Meaning something is missing. In simple sense, there is something missing. If you add something to your Hetu, then it will work. Not all Himsa is Adharma Janika. So you have to qualify that himsa. What? So qualifier is missing. That is an upadhi. So Nayayika say that upadhi is nishiddhatvam. If you say nishiddhatvam himsatvat, but nishiddha himsa. If it is specifically prohibited, then alone it is adharma janika, papa janika. So they say upadhi is what? This sadhya vyapakatve sati. Meaning being along with sadhya. What is sadhya? Adharma janakatvam. So adharma janakatva vyapakatve sati. Meaning wherever there is adharma, there this upadhi has to be there. Meaning sadhya, wherever sadhya, meaning adharma janakatvam is there. Whatever results in adharma papa, there nishiddhatvam is seen. It is, why is, does it generate papa? Because the Shruti says do not do this. It is prohibited. A prohibited action will result in papa. Therefore, wherever there is adharma janakatva, meaning yatra yatra adharma janakatvam tatra tatva niyamena nishiddhatvam. This is sadhya vyapakatvam. What is sadhana avyapakatvam, which has to be there for the upadhi definition to be fitting? Sadhana avyapakatvam is himsatva avyapakatvam, because sadhana is himsa. Himsa is adharmajanika, meaning himsa is what sadhana. Himsa leads to adharma, papa. So papa is sadhya, meaning not papa, papa is janakatvam. Adharma janakatvam is sadhya. So nishiddhatvam is together with, wherever there is adharma janakatvam, there nishiddhatvam is definitely there. But sadhana avyapakatvam means what? Wherever there is sadhana, this himsatva is wherever himsatva. Himsatva is sadhana. Wherever himsatva is there, there nishiddhatvam is not seen. Not everywhere there is himsa, there is no nishiddhatvam. For example, Kshatriya Raja is supposed to fight the battle. He is supposed to make all his Kshatriya army to fight. Why Krishna himself has taken up, Bhagavan Krishna has taken up Sudarshan Chakra and has done so much of himsa. We cannot say it is not himsa. Cutting off the head of someone is not, cannot be considered as not himsa. It is himsa. But it is not nishiddha. Fighting war, soldiers who are on the border protecting the country, fighting a war, it is not a nishiddha karma. It is himsa all right. There is lot of himsa, but it is not nishiddha, because it is a duty as ordained. Kshatriya's dharma is to protect the other varnas. So the Kshatriya is following dharma actually, but his dharma includes lot of himsa. There is no nishiddhatvam there. It is actually ordained. There is no nishiddhatvam. There is vidhitvam, no nishiddhatvam. So here also we will say that upadhi. So what will you have to say? So any objection to this has to have this upadhi as hetu. So what should the Purvapakshi be saying to make his anumana valid? He should be saying kartrantarvartini himsa adharma janika himsatvat. But what himsatvat? He has to say the hetu should be what? Nishiddhatve sati himsatvat. Nishiddhatve sati himsatvat. Now you say kartrantarvartini himsa adharma janika. Why? Himsatvat is working, but if he has to say nishiddhatve sati himsatvat, it won't be. Why? Because kartruantarvartini himsa is what? It is a vidhi. Vidhi cannot be nishiddha. Vidhi is saying you do it. It is not saying you don't do this. So when it says you do it, it cannot be adharma janika. This is the counter to the claim made by the Purvapakshi by saying ashuddham iti chet. So ashuddham means he has done papa karma. Therefore, iti chet, there has to be what? Tasmat janishruti samsarga matra avipraya na mukhya is questioned by the Purvapakshi by saying ashuddham iti chet. No, why? Because this ashuddhatvena papa karma vatvena, because of papa karma what? This janishruti has to be taken as mukhya, meaning there has to be dukkha for the jiva who is travelling from Swarga, because he attained Swarga through papa karma, which is yagarupa himsa, himsa karma. Therefore, this papa is balanced now, and thereby this janishruti should be mukhya, whereby he'll feel the pain, he'll feel dukkha as he comes down and takes the womb through various shariras. If that is the question, ashuddham iti chet na shabdat. There, this the yaga, pashu himsa in the yaga is not a papa karma, it is not ashuddha. No, why shabdat? Because vidhi itself is there. Vidhi says that you do it. So that is the meaning here. Nanu jyotishtoma adikam karma pashu himsa adi yogal ashuddham. This jyotishtoma yaga which the jiva has done to kamya karma to reach swargaloka, that karma is what? Pashu himsa adi yogad ashuddham. It is ashuddha papa janaka. Why? Because of pashu himsa adi yogad, because of having pashu himsa ityadi. तत्कारिणाम अनुशयिनाम व्रीहादि स्थावरेषु दुःखानुभवार्थं मुख्यमेव जन्म अस्तु इति चेन्न. एंड देयर बाय व्हाट तत्कारण मीनिंग ज्योतिष्टोमादि कारीज, दोज हु हैव डन ज्योतिष्टोम इत्यादि पशुहिंसा कर्म, दे विल गेट स्वर्ग ऑल राइट, बट आफ्टर द स्वर्ग सुखभोग दे आर अनुशयी पाप कर्म वन सो फॉर देम वॉट इज रिटेन्ड सम फल ऑफ पापा ड्यू टू डूइंग हिंसा टू अ पशु दैट इज रिटेन्ड एंड देयर बाय व्रीहादि स्थावरेशु दुखानुभवार्थम मुख्यमेव जन्मस्तु दिस जन्म विच इज देयर स्टार्टिंग विथ वॉट व्रीहादि स्थावरेशु स्टार्टिंग विथ व्रीहादि एंड एंडिंग विथ वॉट एवर यू नो काइंड ऑफ अ क्रॉप जन्म एंडिंग विथ यू नो दि वृक्ष इत्यादि जन्म सो ऑल दैट विल बी dukkha dukkha producing dukkha because the husk will be taken away beat and all that will be there cut etc all that let it be mukhya because this jiva who is traveling there let him have dukkha because it is a phala for his pashu himsa in the earlier janma which led to the swarga loka mukhyam eva janmastu iti chedna siddhanti says no it is not so why shabdat why because vidhi shastra has told him it cannot be that the shastra says you do this and then also give dukkha if the shruti which is like thousands of mothers it is bhagwan bhashyakara elsewhere says I think shata or sahasra matru hiteshini it is like hundreds or thousands of mothers this shruti is there which cannot be giving dukkha to the astika by saying you do this and suddenly trapped by saying that okay now that you have done it you will get dukkha that can't be so even a single mother wouldn't want her child to face dukkha what about the shruti then so shabda vidhi shastra because vidhi shastra is there agnishtomadehe dharmavatvena agnishtomadehe dharmatvena avagatatvatna dukkha hetutvam ityartha because what is understood when you study shastra properly is that agnishtoma jyotishtoma ityadi yagas काम्य कर्माज आर ऑल्सो वॉट दे आर धर्म धर्मत्वेन अवगतत्वात् बिकॉज दे आर धर्म ऑफकोर्स देर आर सम अधर्म ऑल्सो डिस्कस्ड फॉर एग्जाम्पल शेनयाग इज ऑल्सो इट इज नॉट गिवन एज अ विधि शेनयाग इज डिस्कस्ड देर हू शुड डू इट समबडी हू वॉन्ट्स टू किल द एनिमी हर्ट द एनिमी दैट पर्सन इज एनी वे गोइंग टू हर्ट द एनिमी एंड ही मे एंड अप हर्टिंग और किलिंग मेनी अदर्स in the vicinity just because of this anger so the person who is anyway going to kill the other for no reason whatever may be the reason it has nothing to do with the dharma karya because of jealousy anger whatever it is revenge all these ideas are there so if the person goes out and starts killing then that has a greater possibility of ending with more and more papa in the vicinity also and it will disturb the society also therefore the shruti says that if at all you want to do it you do shena karma because it is not given to someone else who does not want to do himsa one who wants to do himsa positively has such kind of a mind to him some means are given okay you get over your anger by doing this yaga whereby doing this yaga there also pashubali is there that pashubali will lead to papa Because it is said that you do this only to take care of your enemy, since you cannot drop that anger. And instead of doing greater harm, you do lesser harm, meaning what? You do harm to your enemy and to yourself by earning papa, not to others who are here and there surrounding the person who to whom you are going to give this kind of a punishment that you think or whatever himsa you are going to do to a particular person around them, around him there are others also. So don't affect them that will lead to more papa or socially also society will have a look at this and then it will disturb that will be greater papa than you sit in a yagashala and do this yaga you will end up killing the enemy but then you will earn papa as well so those are exceptions their himsa which is not ordained their papa will be there it is not a vidhi there it is प्रतिषिद्ध कर्म हाउ शुड यू डू प्रतिषिद्ध कर्म दैट इटसेल्फ इज मेंशन देयर बाय व्हाट विधि शास्त्र शब्दात मीन्स ड्यू टू विधि बीइंग देयर अग्निष्टोमादि और ज्योतिष्टोमादि कर्म आर नॉट पापजनिका दे आर धर्म धर्मत्वेन अवगतत्वा सिंस इट इज वेरी वेल नोन बाय आस्तिकास दैट इट इज अ धर्म न दुःख हेतुत्वम इत्यर्थः The reason today it is not done is because the government has prohibited. Very unfortunate. It is unfortunate only because other religions keep on doing all sorts of himsas. Within the Sanatana Hindu religion also there is a lot of himsa outside of the Yaga. But in the Yaga, only in the Sanatana Vaidika Yaga, government has prohibited the Pashubali. But very unfortunate. It has a very, political and different kind of a anti-Hindu kind of a reading there. But anyway, that's an aside. Kincha. Moreover, Retasigyogotha. Further what? Retasigyoga. Further what? There is Retasicha Saha Yogaha. So, Kincha, moreover, the Siddhanti is saying what? The yoga, retasik is one, the purusha, who is going to beget a child by having sanyoga with his patni. So this retasik yoga is for this jiva. The jiva who is traveling has to be associated with the purusha who will become his father basically. So he has to enter the father's, meaning the future father's sharira. Just give me a moment, please. There's an alarm ringing. Yeah, the mobile was away for charging. So, Retasig Yoga, Yogota, Retasig Yoga, Atha. So, Retasig Yoga is a samasa. This person, this traveler jiva, not person, this traveler jiva has to have an association with that Purusha, which we saw is at a particular age, young age, where he has married and he is trying to beget a child, that to be father Purusha has to consume this crop where this Jiva has had association. Then this Jiva enters the father Sharira and then he'll go in the form of seed into the mother's womb and then take Janma. This is the Panchama Ahuti. So, Ritsik Yoga Atha. Thereafter, there is this Ritsik Yoga. Retasik Yoga. Retasik Yoga. Association with the Purusha who is Retasik. Atha Vrihyadi Bhavanantaram. After Atha means after. Thereafter. Thereafter means what? After this Vrihyadi Bhava, which the Jiva has attained, what happens? Anushayinam. Retas Sinchati iti Retas Sik. Retas Sik is the Purusha who will have Sanyoga with the Patni and will implant the seed so that his wife becomes the mother to the child. So that is Retas Sinchati iti Retas Sik Upapada Tat Purusha. So Anushayinam Jivanam, this Jiva who is travelling down, these Jivas who are travelling down from the Swarga Loka, Tadyoga, they have what? Tadyoga, they have the association with the father who is due as Prarabdha Phala to this Jiva. He has to be born into that family and thereby to be born in the womb of that mother, his father is already decided, mother is decided, so he has to have association. Only that father will consume this crop and then Tadyoga, Tadbhavaha, Yoreta Sinchati. Amnayate. So in the Shruti, this has been said, Yaha Retaha Sinchati, one who is going to implant the seed, Tadbhuya Eva Bhavati, this person becomes this traveler Jiva becomes that father. This is what the literal meaning would be. Tadbhuya Eva Bhavati, Tadbhuya means Retasik Bhuya Eva Bhavati, this traveler Jiva will become the father, says this Purva Pakshi. He quotes the Shruti literally and says, Iti Shrutavamnayate Nahi Atra Anushayinam Retasik Bhava Mukhya Sambhavati. Siddhanti answers that no, it is not possible because this yoga association with the father cannot be Tadatme Sambandha. He himself cannot become the father. The Jiva, traveler Jiva is not the father. Traveler Jiva does have Sambandha with the father, but what kind of a Sambandha? He just has Pravesha, that's all. So that he can become the seed. So, Nahi Atra Anushayinam Retasik Bhava Mukhya Sambhavati. It is not a literal meaning. Why? इदानीं पुरुषं प्रविष्टत्वेन अप्राप्त यौवनत्वात् बिकॉज हैविंग एंटर्ड एज अ राइस क्रॉप बीइंग ईटन बाय द पुरुष ही कैनॉट हैव द सडनली दिस जीवा कैनॉट बी बिकम अ युवा He has just entered as a crop. It is going to be digested as food and then across multiple days it will be converted into many dhatus and then finally become the seed of the Purusha. It is not that the suddenly having entered the Purusha's Sharira as a crop, suddenly he will get the Yauvana Bhava. That is not possible. Even a seed which is, rice crop, when you want to make a rice crop or any plant also, it is not immediately that you sow the seed, put water and suddenly it grows up into a crop. It is not so. So similarly, idanim purusham pravishtatvena, just now having entered this purusha, who is going to be the father, aprapte yauvanatvat, this traveler jiva cannot have this yauvanatva immediately. Therefore, it is not literal as to tadbhuye eva bhavati. अतः तद्भाव तत्संसर्गो वाच्य सो रेतसिग योगा इज वॉट द योगा इज तद्भाव और तद्भूय मीनिंग तद्भाव दैट इज तत्संसर्ग इट इज जस्ट एसोसिएशन विद द फादर शरीर हैविंग एंटर्ड देयर इज द एसोसिएशन इट इज नॉट दैट ही इज बिकमिंग वन विद द फादर शरीर सो तत्संसर्गो वाच्य सम संबंध इज देयर मीनिंग द He is the food that he is in the food that has been eaten by the father. That's all it means. Tatha vrihada vapi samsarga eva. Similarly, in the vrihadi also, you go one step back, just like in the with the purusha, in the see this is the fourth ahuti. Fourth ahuti is when the purusha eats the vrihadi. That is the fourth ahuti. So this vrihadi pravesha, which is the third ahuti, also has to be. A sanyoga, which is samsarga, tatsamsarga, just mere association, not tadbhava, meaning literally becoming vrihiyadi. Just like he cannot become the purusha, the father himself, the jiva cannot become the father, the jiva is going to be born to the father. Similarly, vrihiyadi association is a mere association, tatha vrihada vapi samsarga eva, akashada vapi samsargasya eva, avagatatvena sandamsha nyayaditi bhava. So finally, what has been said? We have seen this in whatever little Artha Sangraha we studied, we have seen this Samdamsha Nyaya. Samdamsha Nyaya is, in Mimamsa, the Samdamsha Nyaya is when two similar things are seen in two separate mantras and in between you are trying to analyze the mantra in between these two has what kind of a meaning. Then since the similar meaning, the same meaning is there in the first mantra and the third mantra, this sandwich second mantra, this sandansha means in between the tongues, forceps or the tongues, that kind of a nyaya. The nyaya is what? Whenever there is a sandwiched mantra between two mantras, meaning first mantra, second mantra, third mantra, second mantra is sandwiched between first and the third. If the first and the third have the same contextual meaning, then the second also has the same meaning. So what has been said here? We have seen vrihadu samsarga eva. In the vrihadi, there is samsarga of this traveler jiva. There is no mukhya bhava, mukhya vrihi bhava, vrihadi bhavas. And in the third mantra, this is first, you can take this as the first mantra. And in the third mantra, which is what? In the purusha also what? Samsarga. In the purusha, fourth ahuti, there is samsarga. So in the first mantra, there is, or first set of mantras, there is samsarga, mere association. In the third mantra also, in the fourth ahuti, that is fourth ahuti mantra, there also it is samsarga with the purusha. Then in between, what is that? Vrihadav api samsarga eva. Akashadav samsarga, vrihadav api samsarga eva. I said vrihadav api samsarga, I took that as first mantra. Akashadi is first mantra, you can akashadav. Akashadi varshanta, there is samsarga. We have already proven that. Now, in the fourth ahuti, when the vrihi enters the purusha, there also it is jiva is having samsarga with the purusha. So, in vrihadi, which is sandwiched between the akashadi varshanta, where there is samsarga, and when vrihadi enters the purusha, there is samsarga, jiva has samsarga with the purusha. देन इन बिटवीन दिस व्रीहादव अपि संसर्ग एव बाय संदंश न्याय आई जस्ट टेक अनदर मोमेंट एंड फिनिश दिस ननु अनुशयिनां सर्वत्र संसर्गस्यैव अंगीकारे मुख्यं जन्म क्वापि न स्यात् इत्यतः नाउ दि पूर्वपक्षी सेज देन वेर इज दि मुख्य जन्म एवरीवेर दे संसर्ग आकाशादि देर इज अ मियर एसोसिएशन ऑफ दिस ट्रैवलर जीव देन वर्षांत ऑल्सो टिल देर इज संसर्ग ओनली मियर एसोसिएशन देन दि शेषकर्मी दोज हू हैव शेषकर्म अनुशयिनां वॉट हैपन्स Always there is only samsarga. Vrihado also samsarga. Purushado also samsarga. With the purusha also there is samsarga. Only mere association everywhere meaning gauna janma. There is no tadatme sambandha. There is no mukhya janma at all. Meaning sarvatra samsarga seva angikare. If at all you and I accept only samsarga matra. Only association with all kinds of forms. Then this traveler jiva will never have mukhya janma. Nowhere. Kvapi. Nowhere will he have mukhya janma. Mukhya janma, mukhyam janma, kvapi na syad. Nowhere will this traveler jiva have mukhya janma at all. Ichyataha to that. In the last sutra, Bhagavan Sutrakara says, yonesh shariram, yonesh shariram. He says it is not so. Why? Because in the yoni there is this yoni sharira, yonehe shariram. The sharira is of the yoni there, yonehe. Brahmanadi yonitaha shariram. This panchami is apadane panchami. From which there is birth. Sharira which is born. Shariram yonehe. Yonehe brahmanadi yonitaha. From the brahmana ityadi varna stri. From that yoni there is sharira born. That sharira is the mukhya janma of the jiva. As we were seeing that, since the person has done punya karma and has gone to swargaloka, the janma will be in the yoni. It will be jarayuja kind of a form, but it will not be any other form because this person has gone to swarga, mostly his punya karma is in abundance. Therefore, it will not be less than 50%, so he will mostly take manushya janma. This is what we have seen. But it can be other janma also possible where there is, cow, etc., where there is yoni janma, janma from the yoni. That is the sutra artha. The vritti says yonau retasi nishikte. In the panchami ahuti, what happens? The purusha implants retas in the yoni of the stri patni. So yonau retasi nishikte sati. When that is done, tataha, after the gestation period, what? Tataha sukadukha upabhog yogyam karma uparjitam shariram anushayinam jayate. So for the anushayis, what happens? The shesha karma one purushas, what happens? The jivas who are traveling, they, for them sharira, which is what? Karma uparjita, which is earned due to the earlier karma, which is what? Yogya. That sharira is yogya for what? Upabhoga of sukha and dukkha. Till then there is no sukha dukkha bhoga. So sukha dukkha upabhoga yogyam shariram, which is due to the karma of the jiva, earlier karma, karma uparjitam, anushayinam jayate. For these shesha karmis, the traveler jivas, the sharira is born, iti ramaniya charana ityadi shastrama. This is what the ramaniya charana, those who have ramaniya acharana, those who have punya karma, that kind of a shastra said. Tasmad brahmanadi yonau eva anushayinam mukhyam janma na vrihadau iti gatyagati viveka krutam vairagyam jnana sadhanam itya anavadyam. So here in the first pada of the adhyaya is what? It is a sadhana pada. Sadhana adhyaya. In sadhana adhyaya, the first pada is talking about vairagya specifically. So therefore what? Tasmad brahmanadi yonau eva anushayina mukhya janma. Where is the mukhya janma for this traveler jiva? Only in brahmanadi yoni, manushya yoni. Therefore, earlier to that, all that sharira that this jiva has associated with, it is not mukhya janma. Therefore, na vrihadau iti. So, vrihadau kim na? Mukhyam janma na. So, there is no mukhya janma. It is mere association. Iti gatya gati viveka kritam. By looking at the gati, going to swargaloka and agati meaning coming from the swargaloka, having seen that gatya gati viveka kritam vairagyam. Once you understand who will go to swargaloka, who will come back, and who will not go, where will he go, जायस्व मीर्यस्व इत्यादि लुकिंग एट सच काइंड ऑफ अ ट्रेवल मीनिंग वॉट हियर ऑल्सो इफ द पर्सन गोज टू स्वर्गलोक स्टिल ही इज टू बी बॉर्न हियर सो वैराग्य विल बी उत्पन्न वाई बिकॉज वन नोज दैट वॉट एवर कर्म आई डू कर्मा कैन गिव मी फला विच विल नेवर लास्ट इवन द सुख इन द स्वर्गलोक विल नॉट लास्ट देयर फोर देर विल बी दुखा वाइल कमिंग डाउन जस्ट बिकॉज आई विल नॉट हैव एनी मोर स्वर्गवास दैट इट सेल्फ इज दुखा बट देन आफ्टर दैट देर इज नो दुख इन दी वेरियस एसोसिएशन टिल द पर्सन इज बॉर्न बट वंस बॉर्न इन अ वूम देन स्टार्टिंग विद द गर्भवास इट सेल्फ देर इज दुख सो द दुख विल नॉट गो अवे बाय कर्म दिस इज वॉट विल रिजल्ट इन वैराग्य गत्यागति विवेक कृतम वंस यू डू विवेक देर एज टू ओके स्वर्ग इज देर देर इज सुख देर एंड देर इज नो दुख वेन वन फॉल्स फ्रॉम आकाशादि टू वर्षांत एंड गृहादि ऑल्सो देन वॉट इज द प्रॉब्लम देर इज अ प्रॉब्लम बिकॉज दिस जन्म मरण साइकिल विल नेवर गो एंड दुख इज हियर इन दिस लोका एज वेल लॉर्ड ऑफ दुख इज देर देर फॉर वैराग्यम ज्ञान साधनम वैराग्य बिकम्स द ज्ञान साधन टू लीड टू मोक्ष इति अनवद्यम दिस इज द फॉल्टलेस एनालिसिस डन बाय द सूत्रकार एंड इन द वृत्ति इट हैज बीन एक्सप्लेन सो इति ब्रह्म इति श्री ब्रह्म तत्व प्रकाशिकायां तृतीय अध्याय से प्रथम पाद सो द फर्स्ट चैप्टर फर्स्ट पाद क्वार्टर इन द फर्स्ट थर्ड चैप्टर इन ब्रह्म तत्व प्रकाशिका विच इज ब्रह्म सूत्र वृत्ति दैट एंड्स एंड वी लुक एट द द्वितीय पाद इन द नेक्स्ट पाठ आम्नायन्ते संसिद्धमाधिम अध्यान्तवर्जितम् आनन्दघनमापूर्णमात्मज्योतिरुपास्महे नमस्ते धन्यवादः
नमस्ते नमस्ते थैंक यू